You may be seated. And as you go to your seat, we want to talk on this subject, the prayers of a mother. The prayers of a mother. Some of us don't really realize who really got us where we are. I mean, some of us are just big and bold enough to think that we got where we are on our own. Nobody helped me. I know mama cooked and all and washed my clothes, but nobody got me where I am. But you got to remember, somebody had to pray for you. They had you on their mind. They took a little time just to pray for you. But then when you turn around and want to brag about who you are and where you got yourself, you know, that's something I don't understand today. I can't understand how somebody can say, I'm a self-made man. Anybody here know what that means? I know what we think it means. It means that they got where they are by working hard and gained their money and everything. Nobody gave them anything. But you had to be blessed by God. Somebody had to pray for you to get where you are.
Amen.
Now, when you're out of work, mom prayed for you.
Yes.
When you were in school, mama prayed for you.
Yes.
Prayed for your safety. Prayed for you to get your education. Prayed for you to just be safe at school all day. Mother prayed even after you got home. She prayed, Lord, let my son or my child get home safely.
Yes.
Mother prayed. And don't you think it brings joy to her heart when she can look back and see those of us who know and when we have had mothers, and some of you still have them, that look and just you just bring joy to their eyes because they're able to see how you have matured and how you have come through on their prayers.
Yes.
I'm not saying the fathers didn't pray either, but you didn't get entangled with his spirituality like you did mama's. Mama was the one that got you ready on Sunday morning and shipped you off to Sunday school. You know, and sometimes daddy didn't even go to church. But mama carried you anyhow. Come on, somebody. I know I'm conjuring up some memories now. After you ate a breakfast that seemed like dinner. Yeah, you had that steak and gravy and rice and some eggs and hot biscuits and some ice water. They wouldn't let you drink no coffee because they told you Louisiana coffee made you black. Somebody remember what I'm talking about here? Yeah, but mama was the one that got you started every day in your life. And she prayed for you. And here, you know she had, number one, there's a celebration when a prayer is answered. We sometimes don't understand how God do what he do. Well, it ain't up for you to understand it. Your thoughts are not God's thoughts and his ways are not your ways.
Yes.
I don't know how he do things. All I know he's just doing. I don't have to prove to you or nobody else that God's been good to me.
Yes.
I don't have to stand in on a window stand and testify how good God been. I can do that on the street corner.
Amen.
God has been good to me.
Yes.
Amen. People, somebody prayed that I would go where I'm going. And that I would get to where I'm at. And there's a celebration that we have to realize. And once God has delivered you and out of the prayers of the saints, the Bible lets us know that the prayers of the saints, of the righteous, availeth much.
Yes.
Mother was a righteous person. Mother told you a lot of things about living. Number one, she told you how to be respectful. Mother told you how you have to give respect in order to get respect. Mother told you how to protect yourself in several different ways. Yes, sometimes we conjure up memories of her sweet voice. Whispering in our ear, telling you when you're wrong and when you're right.
Yes.
Doesn't it seem good to celebrate mama today?
Yes.
Because of the way she handled you when you were rambunctious, hard-headed, stubborn, didn't want to do what you were told to do. That old woman don't know me. She old, her old ways is just that. She did that. I know what's going on. Well, I got news for you. They didn't come here being old. They went through the same thing you went through. Huh? All young ladies need to listen, because mama taught you how to take care of yourself. I'm talking about hygiene-wise. Mama taught, well, I can tell you that about me. My grandmother taught me how to take care of myself. You know, I mean, she used to tell me you got to wash yourself and keep your arms from stinking. Later on, I found out what she meant. You know, but that ain't all she told me. You know, you got to, I mean, mothers can tell you a lot of things if you would just loosen your hard head up and listen. She'll set you on the right path. Why is it so, preacher? Well, I'm glad you asked, because as my grandmother says, she can look further in the rock than you can pick. Life is hard. And if you don't listen and you're hard-headed, you're going to find that out. Son, there's trouble down there. Stay away from this. Don't do that. Don't hang around with that crowd. You'll mess around and get in trouble. And they tell you trouble is easy to get into, but it's hard to get. Come on, somebody. Mama didn't give you no bad advice. Then when we look at how we celebrate Mama today, not only did she tell you about that aspect, but she told you how to be a good housekeeper, a good cook, what ingredients to mix with what not to put in food, how long to take it and cook it, and how long to keep it, what to throw out and what to keep. Well, there were many times I've seen my grandmother. Oh, this was something good, y'all. Take old biscuits and make bread pudding. Yes. Oh, y'all know about that thing right there. She would just take them old biscuits that she make and make that good, crumb them all up and put raisins and spice in it and everything. And boy, when she cook it and whip up some sugar and milk and stuff in the bowl and pour that icing over that, and you dip that good. Red, what's up? Good. Y'all mouth watering already. I know. Ready to go, ain't you? But Mama knows how to make do with what she has. She taught you that don't let anything keep you from being sufficient in your living.
Yes.
How many of us remember how Mama used to take leftover peas and make some soup? Them peas were better the next day than it was when she first cooked them. How many of us know that Mama sometimes don't want nothing in the shed, don't want nothing in the refrigerator, but she knew how to make a meal.
Yes.
Yeah. She knew how to provide for her family.
Yes.
Number two, a worship service. She taught you godly things. How to be a godly person. Well, some of us listened and some of us didn't. We had to do it our way.
Yes.
Learn the hard way.
Yes.
We had to do it like we thought, because we didn't know any better. And we thought we knew better. But you see what it got us? The error in our ways, when we thought we were doing things like we wanted to do it, we had to turn around and do it like Mama said anyway. And we wasted a lot of time. So you see, Mama knew all of these things prior to us coming. She was taught by her parents. Well, there was a closer knit to her upbringing than there was to yours.
Oh, yeah.
Have you noticed nowadays that it seemingly, Sister Branch brought it up, there are more single parents and they are younger than they ever been before.
Yes.
Oh, I know folk can argue that Mary, when she had Jesus, was only 14. That's true. But when you just take a look around, Mother always taught you, you know, and how to just preserve yourself until you were married.
Yes.
But some folk nowadays want to explore life early on. I remember a TV show that was on called the Phil Donahue Show. You all remember that one? Phil Donahue had a group of 11 and 12 year old girls who said that they wanted to have babies.
Yes.
Now let that sink in. They were still babies. Hadn't been here a dozen years and wanted to have another baby. And we see now that that attitude, what it has caused.
Yes.
Children having children. They're out with their mom, they're out with their dad, they're in the street too. When that happens. Why? Because the parent don't know anything more than what the child knows. Well, when you are carried to a worship service and you start to believe and learn the word of God, you start preserving yourself for something greater in God's will for your life, then you can worship him in the spirit of true holiness. You won't give up? No, you won't give up. And you will not lie alone and just stop what you're doing and on your way of growing. A celebration and a worship service. And the last thing is a gift of God and a gift to the Lord. Don't you know that we all are a gift from God?
Yes.
We ought to be a gift to the Lord.
Amen.
Your service shouldn't be to the devil.
Amen.
I mean, we have seen how troublesome it is when somebody leave home and they get in trouble. It's never the same anymore. There's a stigmatization that goes with your character. It's good or it's bad. And when a person is known to have a bad character or reputation, people really, really misjudge them. Because it is God who can give us a new life.
Amen.
It is God who can give us a fresh start. It is God who can rebuild our personality. It is God who can rebuild our spirituality. It is God who can rebuild everything that we want to be. All we got to do is just look back on past examples. Come here, Paul. Paul said, I was the chiefest of sinners. I was on my way to Damascus.
Yes.
I was going to arrest the children and men and the women. Anybody that was in the way. I had a letter that gave me the authority. Yes, I was known as a bad man. But on my way to Damascus,
yes,
a light from heaven shone. Knocked me down. And I heard a voice says, Saul, Saul, why persecute thou me? I got up, but I couldn't see anything.
All right.
I heard him say, go to the city, to a street called Straight.
Yes.
There you're going to meet a man,
amen,
named Ananias,
yes,
who will tell you everything,
okay,
that you need to do.
Yes.
Paul's attitude and his character swiftly changed. Because after 3 long days of being blind, Ananias dipped him once in the name of the Father,
yes,
dipped him twice in the name of the Son,
yes,
dipped him a third time in the name of the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
And when Paul came up out of the water,
yes,
he was able to see, yes,
right,
I'm sure,
yes,
that Paul had a praying mother.
Uh-huh.
But he went on his evil ways. I'm sure, just like you and I, sometime in our innate minds, we were doing what we thought we were big enough to do. But somewhere, a praying mother was looking out for us. Sometimes, we may not agree with our parents, but they know what's best for us. When we get big enough and think we know everything, God will,
yes, he will
step in,
yes, he will,
right on time.
Yes.
And I'm so glad,
amen,
everybody here,
uh-huh,
has a mother.
Yes.
If you don't have one now, you used to have one.
Yes.
And she prayed for you.
Yes.
But the prayers of a mother can avail much.
Yes.
her mouth. Eli, thought Hannah was drunk. But Hannah said, no, my Lord. I'm tired of getting picked on. P.M. or P.9. Just picks on me. All the time. She had given my husband, Elkanah, several children, sons and daughters. But I'm unable to give him any children. I'm down here on my knees, praying daily that the Lord will open my womb and give me a child. And Lord, if you give me a son, I'll give it back to you. The Bible said she went in and knew her husband and conceived. And the Lord gave her a son, and she named him Samuel. Old Samuel said his hair would not be cut. Old Samuel, once he was weaned, was taken to the temple and raised by the priest. And Samuel became one of God's strongest prophets. This same Samuel, was able to save a lot of folk. He's the one that told a man from another country, go dip in the Jordan 7 times and you shall be clean. Old Samuel had it right, but his mother had prayed for him. He was a man of God. For all I'm telling you, that if your mother had not prayed for you, think about where you'd be today. You'd be lost in a world that don't care a thing about us. But she warned you, told you, stay away from trouble. Stay away from that crowd. But some of us were stiff-necked, hard-headed, had to do it anyway. But look at God, how he brought us back to reality. Look at God, how he's kept us. Look at God, how he got his arm wrapped around you. Is so important. And I know some of us don't know how we're going to get through. But when mama prayed, there's something like she got a secret line straight to God's bosom. Yes. And I know sometimes we wonder, how in the world did this get done? I didn't ask for this blessing, but look what God had done for me. Somebody prayed for you. Had you on their mind. Took a little time to pray for you. Amen. Amen. That's the message for today. I extend the gospel invitation to those who are unsaved and want to come at the meal. Of course, get ready to sing. We're soon to leave this place. But if you are unsaved,